why I get upset with, like, where is Steve Sweeney on this? Like, that's a legitimate question. That you've got this state program, and out of 8,000 people, 7,680 have signed what they're calling their awards from the Community Affairs Department, which means they've now got an allocation of money to go and move forward and do it. Well, you can't do that if the contractor backed out and he's from Texas. Well, and Steve said it. What's he going to do? He's going to sue him? And that, how much is that going to cost? Joe and Amanda, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. You guys, I appreciate you waking up with us early. I know you're out in front of the State House right now. How's the weather?
Not bad. It was. We had some torrential storms last night, but you know what? I'll take rain over gunshots any day.
There you go. There you go. Okay. I mean, it's Trenton. You never know what you're going to get.
So, we got a little of both the last 2 days.
Joe and Amanda, I you know, we talked yesterday, and you know, I pointed out that there is a number that is about 98%. When you look at the 365,000 homes that were damaged or destroyed by Hurricane Sandy, 98% back on track. And the challenge we have is it's with this REM program, with the Community Affairs Department in New Jersey, out of more than 8,000 people, almost 7,700 have signed their awards. But then you find out only 3 years later, only 2,000 homes have been completely rebuilt. So why are you out in front of the State House this morning? You've been there for 3 days.
I mean, that is exactly it. And, you know, I tried to look into that, to that big number where we ended up with 2%. And I don't like to make stuff up, so I'm going to be honest with you, and I'll tell you. I don't actually know. I couldn't find the source of that number. And, in fact, I called a couple of reporters who wrote that quote, and they're looking into it, too. So I'll tell you what I do know.
Mm-hmm.
If talking about being back in your home, that means you had enough damage or destruction that you actually had to get out of your home. And so many more people had damage in Sandy, but didn't have to leave their homes. And that was serious damage, too, and that was expensive damage, too. But if we're counting how many people are home, we need to count how many people were forced to leave their home.
Well, that's
that number, that number, as reported by the state of New Jersey, was 40,500 owners of primary homes. If you're looking at 40,500, that's a different number, right?
Yeah.
And 15,000 of those, 15,000 people initially applied for the REM program. Now, still standing in that program today are about 8,300 total.
Right.
Now, some of those people, they didn't make it in because probably it wasn't the right program for them. But 4,000 of the people that didn't make it in, the state can't account for where they are or why they're not in it. Then you look at the 8,300 that are still standing, and you know that less than 2,000 of the people in that program are home for good today, 2 years later. That, I can tell you, that doesn't mean 2%. And that's really serious, and that's what's got us out here saying.
So, what do you hope to accomplish,
Amanda?
Why
are you out here in the rain? We have nowhere to go.
What do you hope to accomplish? Because I think what Steve brought up, the caller earlier, this is a very serious point. That there's a bureaucracy. It's a problem with contractors and insurance. And the question I have is, how are the politicians? How are they helping you if they're all pointing the finger at the governor and grandstanding on this, when you've got members of Congress that haven't said anything about it? And we know that the problem started with FEMA. We know that if a contractor backs out of it and the state tells you you've got a deadline, you could end up losing that money.
Mm-hmm.
Right? I mean, how many people didn't get what they expected with their flood insurance? Now, there's something that I'd like to see Congresswoman Bonnie Watson Coleman spend some time on instead of, you know, taking pot shots at the cops in Trenton. All right, so what do you think, Amanda?
Well, I think actually Joe's in an even better position to answer this. But, yeah, there's been a mess on a whole bunch of levels. The federal government, huge problems with FEMA. People were chronically underpaid by flood insurance. It's part of the reason we're still struggling. But one of the things we're focused on is, like, what can we do right here, right now, our community, the people in New Jersey, our lawmakers who can make a difference. And that example of the contractor that you were talking about, right before we hopped on, and thank you again for having us this morning.
Yeah, you bet.
It is lovely to have something to do while we're hanging out here watching the sunrise. There is a law that was introduced by Senator Beck that would extend accountability and protection to Superstorm Sandy survivors that are in this particular program we're talking about right now.
Yeah.
All we need to do is pass it. All we need to do is pass it. And so that's one of the reasons we're here across from the State House, right? There are actual laws that are starting to move, but we need to get them.
So what will Senator Beck's legislation do, so I understand it? Because that's something I'd love to talk about.
Right, totally. So, and actually, honestly, I'm sure she'd be willing to call in too. She sure knows more about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you know what? We're going to call, Kara, can we call Senator Beck's office? I'd love to talk to Senator Jen Beck this morning.
Yeah, and we worked this. With her. We met with her twice to sort of share our stories and experiences. So, you know, my overview and why we're fighting for it is right now, the way that fraud is framed doesn't include a lot of what people are experiencing. And you know what else is crazy? Right now, like the person that's walked away from the contract that walked away from, I think it was Steve, with the money and isn't doing the job. And what's Steve going to do? Like spend years trying to sue him to get the money back?
Right.
Well, this law would make it clear that actually, because it's a state program and it's state money, the state then has to go after the contractors. It gives the state more teeth to hold these contractors accountable. And we need that because we need to hold them accountable. And we need to make it clear.
Yep, I agree.
Our taxpayer money. We want it to work in people's home. We don't want it in Texas with some contractors.
Exactly, well, Amanda. Well said. Well said. But again, back to that point, like I read this article that, you know, I know Steve Sweeney stopped by yesterday and he was crude. You know, he was crude about it. And I think it was just a low class way to handle it. And I was disappointed because now you're talking about Jen Beck, like how come we didn't hear that yesterday? And I, you know, so I'm glad you pointed it out. I'm going to call Senator Beck now because I want to talk to her about what the legislation is, how it will work. And does she have unanimous support in the legislature? Because something clearly needs to be done. And like I said yesterday, you know, forgetting the folks that if it's their second home that and remember, just for context for everybody, if you're listening to this. And Amanda, I said this to you and Joe yesterday that there are some people on this, that it is a second home. There has been fraud and abuse. There are people that are taking money right out of your pocket because they've cheated the system. And some of that money has already been spent. So I think there's a reason why the process is slow and methodical. On the other side, this is not a slow process. There are people that may not get anything because if your contractor skipped town and will not honor the contract and then your time limit runs out, well, you're out of luck. Yeah. All right. Well, look, Joe and Amanda, thank you for calling New Jersey 101.5. I want to stay in touch with you. Are you going to be out there tomorrow as well?
We are going to be out here tomorrow until noon. If you want to come see us, we'll be out here all day today. And you know,
and all night tonight.
All right.
We were glad to have the senator stop by and because he has also worked to pass bills to help Sandy survivors this August, the Transparency and Accountability Bill. So we're happy to work with any legislator, any side of the aisle that's going to help us get the job done.
All right, good. We may touch base again tomorrow. I will let you know, okay?
Thank you so much.
All right, you bet. Stay warm. Be careful. Okay. Thanks, guys.